Hi everybody, welcome to Learn for Turkey. So today we are going to see how Git commit works in this tutorial, and we will also see how SVN differs from the Git commit process. So let's begin with this tutorial. So in this tutorial we are going to cover how commit works in Git and how it differs from SVN. So these are the steps that we are going to perform to cover this tutorial. So before going through these steps, I will let you know the concept behind the Git commit, and then we will modify a few files and then stage them. And what is staging, we will talk about it in this tutorial, and then we will view staged files, finally commit the staged files. So what is staging and all, we will be explaining in this tutorial. So for this tutorial we have made one project in the NetBeans, very simple project, simple calculator app, and we have already created a repository for this and pushed that code into the repository with the name. The repository name is simple calculator app. You can have the look on this repository after following this tutorial. So this simple calculator app is meant just to show how the commit workflow works in Git. So this is the project folder, simple calculator app, and as we go inside this project folder, this is .git folder which gets added whenever we initially execute command git init. So for that we do not have to have GitHub account, because that represents a local repository. Because as far as a person working on his system without involving the public repository, so that represents the local repository. So these are the folders present in this directory, and .git is meant for the repository purpose. That gets added automatically. So in this project we have added one file, simple calculator app, and one function, add function, and which is being called from the main function, and the output of this is like 6. So we have just shown the simple application. Now this folder itself is a, here whatever is the folder you look like from here to over here, this is actually a working directory. This represents actually working directory. So let me go to the image. Okay, so working directory here, the first box in this process workflow, working directory, represents the folder structure that we have seen. So the Git has introduces one staging area concept, and this is the local repository, means the local storage. This local repository is actually is within the .git folder, and this is remote repo GitHub, means this is the remote GitHub repository. Means whatever, whenever we push, whenever use the git push command to push the code to the public repository, that code will go to the remote repository, means remote storage. So this is public remote storage, this is private remote storage that keeps on your own local system, means local personal computer of a developer. So what is staging area and how it works? So let's see. So in this diagram we have shown F1, F2, F3. Suppose we have edited, or we have few files in the working directory, and we have edited F1, F2, F3 at one go, or 1 or 2 days, and if we issue command git add F1, F2, then this command is actually taking only F1 and F2 in the staging area. This staging area is actually is within the .git folder. This index file actually represents the staging area. So that's why the staging area is also known as index. So whenever we issue this command, F1 F2 gets into the staging area. Means staging area does not directly put the files into the storage, private storage or private repository, that is local repository. It just mark the files that it will be gone into the private storage when you issue commit command. And then only those files which are in the staging area gets committed. Like in this image we have shown F1 F2 gets in the staging area and only F1 F2 gets committed, not the F3. F3 is still here in the working directory. So how git shows this staging files? F1 F2 will be marked as in green color and F3 will be in the red color. So let's see in the netbeans. Suppose we add one more function in this file and name this as sub and do subtraction, and let's call the sub function, and that's it, and let's save it. Okay, so I have modified the file and this is the modification shown by the NetBeans. The green segment shows the new additions to the file and blue segment shows the modification to the file. So let's see how we can see the changes. So if we go to this folder and right click on this and go to the git bash here. So this will come when you install the git software in your system. So we are here in this folder. So if we issue the command git status instead of git log, it's a git status. So it shows that file in red color because that file is modified and is in the working directory. Now to put that file in the staging area, what we do, we will issue a command git add. You can either put dot afterwards to add untracked and newly added files to the staging area, but in this tutorial I am going to show you that particular file in the staging area. So let's copy that location and paste over here. Actually the command hasn't copied, that's why it's complaining that something is missing. So let's put again. Let's copy again. Now this file now gets added to the staging area. So let's fire git status command again. So now this file gets added to the staging area. So you can see that here it is mentioned that changes to be committed, means that file is in the staging area, means this staging area, but not yet committed. To commit this file, we need to issue the command git commit so that it gets added to the local repository. So let's add one more file over here. Let's see by git status command. Now, as you see that we have added one file, and the newly added file is shown as in red color, which is in the working directory and still is not staged yet. So it is also shown over here that it is untracked file, not staged. So this is the file that is in staging area. So if in that scenario, if we issue the git commit command, only the staged file that is marked in green color will be get added to the local repository. So if we issue command git commit minus m sub operation . So after issuing the command, let's again issue the git status. So as you see that only that file which is marked in green color, means which is in staging area, gets committed, and which is in red color, that is remained in the working directory. So you can also see through git log stat command to see the last operation. Means here it is showing that simple calculator app.java is being added to the repository with 7 insertion and 1 deletion. So in this way we have seen that how the staging area works in Git. So how it differs from SVN. So let's look at the picture. In the Git, we have to issue 2 commands to accomplish what SVN in one command. Means first we need to modify the file, that is edit, then we need to issue the git add command to put that file into the staging area, then we have to issue the command git commit to put the files in the staging area to the repository. So we have to issue 2 command instead of 1 command to put the file in the repository. Afterwards, if you want to put the file in the public repository, you need to push it or issue the push command, then it will be in the public repository. So this git add and git commit command is actually 2 command to put the file in the repository. But in case of SVN, if we issue SVN commit, means if that file is already in tracked mode by SVN add, then if we issue SVN commit on this file, then the file directly gets added to the repository, that is remote repository. So SVN puts, there is no concept of staging area in SVN. So in this way we have learned how the git commit works and how it differs from SVN. So we have covered all those points that we have accomplished the objective. So thank you for watching Learn for Taraqi channel, and don't forget to like and subscribe. So we will keep on adding videos on Git and Git basics, and definitely through NetBeans also. So thanks for watching Learn for Taraqi, and do subscribe. So in the upcoming video, we will see how the commits that we have made earlier, or the last commit, how we can modify it, how we can modify the messages that we have put in the last commit, and how we can accomplish the same commit through NetBeans. Thank you.